వెల్కమ్ మై డియర్ బ్రదర్స్ అండ్ సిస్టర్స్ సన్స్ అండ్ డాటర్స్ హౌ ఆర్ యూ ఆల్ టుడే
亲爱的弟兄姐妹和我所亲爱的孩子们，你们可好？欢迎你收看今天的心腹预备整齐。
It is exciting to meet all of you today.
非常高兴又能够再一次的和你聚首了。
Okay, before we proceed any further, I need to ask you one question.
在我们继续分享之前呢，我要问你一个问题。
Have you done your homework?
你有没有做功课啊?
You know, when I was a student in school,
你知道吗? 当我在学校里头还是一个学生的时候,
the teacher will say like this.
老师常常这样说,
okay, all of you do your homework.
每个人都要做功课。
And then the next day when we all come back to school,
那么第二天我们再回到学校,
every one of the students will be hoping and praying that the teacher will forget to ask us about homework.
每个学生呢都会在那边祷告, 希望老师 都忘记了他们的功课。
We'll all be frantically praying and hoping that the teacher will forget.
我们非常迫切地在那边祷告, 希望老师呢会忘记我们的功课，不再问我们。
Sometimes our prayer is answered.
有时候我们的祷告蒙应允。
But many times it is not answered.
但是大多数时候呢却没有应允。
Maybe you are also thinking like that.
可能你现在也正在这样想。
That 1 week had passed by, I would have forgotten.
一个星期过去了，可能我忘记了。
So, have you done your homework?
所以现在问你有没有做功课?
Huh? What homework? You may be asking now.
Huh? 你说是什么功课啊?
I told you to meditate on Ezekiel 16 verse 10.
我告诉你要去默想以西结书16章第10节。
Okay, many of you may have done.
我们很多人已经做了。
Many of you may not have done.
也可能很多人都没有做。
Okay, let's read Ezekiel chapter 16 verse 10 again.
好，这时候我们再一次的来读以西结书16章第10节。
I clothed you in embroidered cloth and gave you sandals of badger skin. I clothed you with fine linen and covered you with silk.
我也使你身穿绣花衣服，脚穿海狗皮鞋，并用细麻布给你束腰，用丝绸为衣披在你身上。
After a bride had made elaborate preparations for using makeup,
当一个新娘用化妆来美化自己之后,
the next most important aspect of her completeness is the bridal gown.
要完成整个装扮的过程呢, 她还必须穿上新娘的礼服。
Now, look at the scripture carefully again.
让我们仔细地再来看这节经文。
God is saying, I clothe you.
神在对我们说, 我为你把衣披上。
Two times it is repeated.
在这里呢, 是重复了两次。
And last week we looked at the first part, what it means that God clothed us with a fine linen and badger skin for sandals.
在上一次呢，我们已经给你解释了，当神给我们身穿这个细麻衣和脚穿海狗皮鞋是什么意思。
If you look at this scripture very carefully,
如果你仔细地看这节经文,
firstly, you will notice two parts of this scripture.
我们将会发现到这节经文有两个部分。The
second thing that you will notice is this.
第二样东西你所发现的是,
the design of the bridal gown is different in the two parts.
这个新娘的礼服呢, 在这节经文当中的两个部分是不一样的。
In the first part, the gown is made of embroidered cloth.
在经文的第一个部分, 我们看到新娘的礼服乃是用绣花所制成的。
And in the second part, the bridal gown is made of fine linen.
在经文的第二部分, 我们看到新娘的礼服乃是用细麻布制成的。
And she had a head covering of silk.
同时她还用丝绸为这个头纱来披上。
So that shows us two different dispensations or seasons that has taken place in the life of a bride.
所以在这节的经文的里头, 我们看到在新娘的身上呢, 其实是经历了两个世代, 或者说是两个季节。
In the first season, she wore embroidered cloth and she had the sandals that was made of badger skin.
在第一个季节，他身穿绣花衣服，脚穿海狗皮鞋。
So that speaks of very rough kind of clothing.
这样的描述呢，让我们看到他所穿的，他的穿着是比较粗糙的。
Why she needed that kind of a rough clothing?
为什么他要穿这么粗糙的衣着呢？
Because the first redeemed church was walking in the wilderness of Mount Sinai.
因为第一次被救赎的教会乃是行走在西乃山的旷野里头。
哈、this is something new.
哈、这么新的教导啊。
You mean you never thought of this before?
那么就是说你从来没有这样想过咯。
Okay, I want you to open your heart and mind now.
好，这个时候我要请你敞开你的心，还有你的心思意念。
We are going to study something deeper now.
我们要进深的去研读。
The church that we know, we are thinking only happened in the New Testament times.
我们常常一想到教会的时候呢，就是想到新约时代的教会。
We know that the church was given birth because out of the death of the Lord Jesus Christ.
我们所想到的教会就是因着主耶稣基督受死之后所产生的教会。
And the church was born out of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ.
这个教会的产生呢，也是出于主耶稣基督的宝血。
It is very true, and I believe that with all my heart.
这是真理来的，我也是全心全意的去相信。
You may now ask me a question.
这时候你可能在问我一个问题。
If I believe that and I claim that to be true,
如果我相信这方面的道理，而且相信它是真理。
How can I say that the church was redeemed first in the Old Testament?
那我为什么又说，在第一次教会被赎的时候是在旧约时候呢？
Let me put your doubts to rest by explaining and pondering deeply now.
来，让我们静深的去研读的时候，盼望能够帮助你消除一切的疑惑。
You must now flip in your mind the Bible to the book of Exodus.
现在希望你在脑海的当中呢，翻到出埃及记。
The birth of a church takes place as a result of redemption by God.
教会的产生乃是由于神的救赎。
Let's look at Exodus chapter 12.
让我们来看出埃及记十二章。
The story of redemption takes place there.
这个救赎的故事呢，就是从出埃及记十二章开始的。
The Israelites were slaves in Egypt for 400 years.
以色列人在埃及为奴四百年。
Now they are going to be born again.
现在他们要重生了。
Do you know that they were born again?
你知道他们是重生的吗？
Not only they were born again, they were also baptized in the water.
不只是他们重生啊，他们还受了水礼。
How were they born again? How were they redeemed?
他们如何重生？如何被救赎呢？
We are born again and redeemed by the flesh of the Lord Jesus' death and by the shedding of his blood.
我们乃是借着主耶稣的受死以及他所流出的宝血而被救赎，而被重生。
I am sure you have no problem believing that and accepting that.
我相信对于这个说法呢，你是可以完完全全的接受，完完全全的相信的。
Look what happens in Exodus chapter 12.
现在让我们来看看出埃及记十二章发生了什么事情。
The Lord God told the prophet Moses.
神对先知摩西说，
Today I'm going to redeem all the firstborn.
今天我将要救赎所有头生的。
Two things are going to take place.
有两样事情将会发生。
One, a death for the guilty.
第一呢，就是要让那一些有罪的人被救赎。
Secondly, a redemption for the righteous.
第二呢，就是要救赎那些为义的人。
So the angel of death was going to go all over Egypt.
所以这死亡的天使将要走遍全埃及地。
All the firstborn are going to die.
所有头生的将会死。
But God told the prophet Moses.
可是神对 先知摩西说
But you are my chosen people.
你们是我所拣选的子民
But you need to be redeemed so that your firstborn do not die.
你们必须被救赎，以至于你们的头生不会死。
How were they redeemed?
要怎么样得救赎呢？
God told the prophet Moses.
神告诉先知摩西
Cut a lamb.
要宰杀一只羔羊
And take the blood and smear on the doorposts of your house.
将羔羊的血呢，涂抹在你的门楣和门框上。
Secondly.
第二。
Roast the lamb and the whole family sit down together and eat the lamb.
你们要烤这一只的羔羊，然后全家坐在一起吃这一只羔羊。
Now what were they doing?
他们在做什么？
They were eating the flesh of the lamb.
他们乃是在吃着羔羊的肉。
And used the blood of the lamb as an appropriation, a covering for them.
而也用羔羊的血来作为他们的一种遮盖。
Now in the New Testament church, we partake the Lord's Supper.
在新约圣经里头呢，我们一起的来守主的圣餐。
We take bread and we take the grape juice.
我们拿着饼和葡萄汁。
And the Lord Jesus himself said in John chapter 6,
主耶稣在约翰福音第六章这样说
that the bread represents his own flesh.
这个的饼就代表他本身的肉体。
And the grape juice represents his own blood.
葡萄汁就代表他所流出来的血。
And if you read 1 Corinthians chapter 11,
要是你去读哥林多前书11
The Apostle Paul also reiterates that truth.
使徒保罗呢，也再一次的重申这一个的真理。
Even he confirms saying the bread represents the flesh of Jesus Christ and the juice, the grape juice represents the blood of the Lord Jesus.
使徒保罗再一次的确定这一个的饼就代表着主耶稣的身体，而葡萄汁代表着主耶稣的宝血。
And right there in Egypt, Lord God gave this concept to the Hebrew children as a foreshadow of what is going to take place thousands of years later in the New Testament.
而在埃及的地方啊，神很早就把这样的一个概念赐给希伯来的孩子们，让他们能够可以尝到和看到几千年后主耶稣的那种本相。
That night when the angel of death walked through the streets of Egypt,
当天晚上，当死亡的天使走遍埃及地的每一条街道，
Every firstborn child and animal were killed.
每一个家庭中的头生的孩子和牲畜都被杀。
But when it came near the house of the Hebrews,
可是当这一位死亡的天使靠近希伯来人的家庭的时候，
When the angel sees the blood on their doorposts,
当这些的天使看到门框门楣上的血，
He passes them over,
他就越过去了。
So they were all safe and protected by the blood.
所以呢，他们因着羔羊的宝血而得保护保守。
AndEarly in the morning, they were all set free from being slaves.
在第二天早上的时候呢，他们完全的得释放，不再成为奴仆了。
That was their day of redemption.
那一天就是他们得救赎的日子。
How did that come about?
这一天是怎么来到的呢？
By the sacrificing of a lamb.
那就是因着一只羔羊牺牲了生命。
By the eating of the flesh and the smearing of the blood.
还有他们吃了羔羊的肉，以及因着涂在门楣门框上的羔羊的血。
So in a sense, they were born again.
所以从这几方面来看的话，他们重生了。
And when they crossed the Red Sea,
当他们渡过红海的时候，
1 Corinthians chapter 10 tells us,
在哥林多前书第十章告诉我们，
They were all baptized in Christ in the Red Sea.
他们乃是在红海的里面，也就是在主耶稣基督的里面受洗了。
Look at this.
让我们来看。
This is a very beautiful picture.
这是一幅非常美丽的图片。
They were redeemed by the blood.
他们是被血所救赎。
They were baptized in the water.
他们在水中受洗。
And then God made them a temple.
然后神把他们组成为一个殿。
Oh, this is very beautiful.
这是非常美丽的。
If you read Exodus chapter 19, verse 6.
要是你去读出埃及记十九章第六节。
The Holy God told them.
神对他们说。
I make you a kingdom of priests.
我乃是让你们作为祭司的国度。
The same truth is found in 1 Peter chapter 2.
同样的真理也可以在彼得前书第二章看得到。
Verse 9 it says, we are made a kingdom of priests.
在第九节说呢，我们是作为神君尊的祭司。
So what happened in the New Testament was foreshadowed in the Old Testament.
所以在新约圣经里头所成就的，其实它的影儿已经在旧约里头可以看见了。
So during their journeys in the wilderness,
所以当以色列人走着旷野路的时候，
God clothed his bride with the clothing that is necessary for a rough journey.
神就赐给他的心腹适当的这个礼服，好让他呢能够抵挡在旷野里头的风沙。
The journey is hard.
因为这是一条崎岖又艰难的旅程。
The weather is very bad.
气候非常恶劣。
So she needs rough clothing.
所以她必须要穿上粗糙的衣服。
Many layered of embroidered clothing.
必须要穿多层绣上花的衣服。
To walk for 40 years in the wilderness.
要在旷野里头行走40年。
She cannot wear high heels.
她不可以穿高跟鞋。
Is it possible?
有可能穿高跟鞋吗？
Women like to wear high heels.
很多的妇女都喜欢穿高跟鞋。
Try wearing that and walk up a mountain.
你试试看穿着高跟鞋去爬山吧。
Or walk among rocks.
或者是穿高跟鞋走在石头上。
You'll keep on falling every step of the way.
相信你每一步呢都会跌倒。
So she needs special badges.Skin made shoes.
所以呢，他需要穿上用海狗皮所做的鞋子。
This reminds me of an incident that happened in my life in June 1986.
这让我想起我生命当中在1986年六月的一起事件。
During the early years of my ministry, I did not wear any sandals on my feet.
在我早期的服侍的当中，我脚上没有穿任何的鞋。
So I walked barefoot all over India.
所以我是赤脚走遍印度各地。
And the Lord led me to go to this northern part of India called Ladakh.
神就带领我到北印度的地方，这个地方呢称为 Ladakh.
I didn't know that whole region of Ladakh is at an elevation of 10,000 feet and above.
Ladakh 这个地方呢，原来是在海拔10,000尺以上的高山。
The highest region that I went during the journey was at 17,000 feet.
我到达最高点的地方呢是17,000尺。
I didn't know all this.
我一无所知。
So we started our journey.In Himachal Pradesh.
那么我们就从这个地方呢起行了。
So it's a beautiful state in northern part of India called Himachal Pradesh.
这个地方称为 Himachal Pradesh, 是一个非常漂亮在北印度的地方。
So there we pass by beautiful hill country.Called Kulu and Manali.
我们经过非常漂亮的山庄，那就是 Kulu Manali.
And after that, we need to take a bus to go to Ladakh.
那么到达那个地方之后呢，我们必须要坐巴士才会到达 Ladakh.
So from there, we reach a village called Darcha.
来到一个村庄称为 Darcha.
Darcha is the border village between Himachal Pradesh and Kashmir.
这个的村庄呢是介于两地之间的一个中间的界限。
Since there is a border area,
正因为这是一个边界的地方。
Every Indian's even who are not from the local area who want to go to Ladakh must register at the police station.
所以呢，任何一个要进到从印度去的拉达的人呢，他们一定呢要向这个警察局呢来，注册。
So when the police officer came to take down our particulars,
当这些的警察来把我们的细节写下来
，as soon as he saw me,
一旦他看到我
，he said, "Namaste, Babaji."
他说 ，"Namaste, Babaji."
Namaste means like a wishing or greeting to someone in the Hindi language.
哦，原来这个警察呢是用新都语来问候萨都牧师。
And the word "Babaji" is strictly means.Holy Father.
Babaji 的意思呢，相等于神父。
Is the Hindu people give very great respect to priests?
也就是这些的啊，新都徒呢，对于他们的祭司一个非常的一个尊称。
So as I was registering my particulars,
所以当我把我的那些的细节记录下来
，the police officer looked at me.
有一个警察就看着我
，and he noticed that I was barefoot.
他看到我是赤脚的。
So he said, "Babaji, where are your shoes?"
他问我说，尊敬的神父，你的鞋子在哪里
？I said, "I am not wearing any shoes."
我说我是没有穿鞋的。
Oh, then he felt very sad.
他的心里面非常难受。
He said, "I'm sorry to say this, Babaji."
他说。对不起，亲爱的神父，我要对你说。
The army has very strictly ordered that anyone who wants to cross into Ladakh must be properly attired with shoes.
那么那里的军人告诉我们呢，要是任何人要进到 Ladakh 这个地方呢，他必须要穿好鞋子。
Because you need to walk high altitude across snow-covered mountains.
因为呢，你必须要爬上非常高的地方呢，去到那些有雪覆盖的大地。
And at those high altitudes among the snows, if we are not properly dressed, the weather can cause the flesh in the skin to all melt and drop off.
要是你没有穿上适当的鞋子，在高山又有大雪的地方呢，你的脚上的这些的肉啊，就会一一的溶解，然后脱落。
So I told him, you know, nothing will happen to me.
我告诉他，没关系的，不会有事情发生在我身上。
He said, "Babaji, I believe you."
他说，神父，我相信你。
But the army will not allow you to walk.
但是呢，这些的军兵不会让你走过去的。
So I told him, "Where can I go and buy shoes in this village?"
于是我问他，在这个村落里头，我能够到什么地方去买鞋子呢
？He said, "I don't know that, Babaji."
他说，对不起，这一点我并不知道。
But in the morning, you must have shoes.
可是明天早上你来到这里的时候，你必须穿上鞋。
So he left.
他就离开了。
And I now didn't know what to do now.
这时候我真的是不知所措。
So I prayed.
于是我祷告。
Lord, you are the one who brought me here.
主啊，是你把我带到这里来的。
You clearly showed me the very direction where I should go.
你很清楚地指示我，我应该往哪一个方向走。
Now hear what this officer had just said.
可是刚才那个警察告诉我。
So please make a way, Lord.
所以请你为我开路。
The following morning.
第二天早上。
This officer came.
这一位警察又来了。
Say, "Babaji, have you found your shoes?"
亲爱的神父，你已经找到你的鞋子了吗
？I said, "No, I don't have."
告诉他，对不起，没有。
And then he stretched his hand.
他就伸出他的手。
Say, "Babaji, I brought you some shoes."
我带了一双鞋子给你。
That police officer himself went and got me a pair of shoes.
那位的警察先生为我买了一双鞋子。
He said, "This is what the local people wear to walk in this region."
这就是本地的人呢要到这个地区行走的时候所穿的鞋子。
When I looked at the shoes,
当我看着那双鞋子
，it doesn't look like any shoes that normal people wear.
它并不像一般人所穿的鞋子。
So I asked the officer, "What kind of shoes are these?"
我就问那位警察先生，这是什么样的鞋子
？He said, "The local Ladakhi people wear this kind of shoes." To walk in this high extreme weather.
他说，当地的拉达基的人呢，就是穿这一种的鞋子，才能够在那种这么高的地方、恶劣的天气里头行走。
The whole shoes is made of straws.
整双的鞋子啊，是用稻草制成的。
The very kind of straws that cows eat.
也就是呢，牛所吃的稻草。
And they are all like intertwined with one another very hard and they made the shoes.
那么这些的稻草呢乃是一根接一根的给编织在一起所以整双的鞋子是非常坚硬的。
And the under part of the shoe, the soles were made of cow dung.
那么鞋子的下面呢是用牛粪所制成的。
So it is very sturdy for the harsh winter or Himalayan climate.
所以呢在这双的鞋子非常适合于在喜马拉雅山的地方呢来行走。
So I put it on and tied it around my legs.
于是呢我把它穿上然后系好。
It is very, very unpleasant.
哦感觉非常不舒服。
Very rough.
因为太粗糙了。
And when I started walking with that,
当我穿着这双鞋子开始行走。
The straws were so sharp and they began to cut into my skin.
这些的稻草非常的利于是呢就割伤了我的脚。
And the cow dung under the sole was so sturdy that it lasted an entire journey of 12 days.
那么这鞋底下的牛粪是那么的厚以至于它能够帮助我走完了12天的路程。
So to walk in the wilderness, you need those kind of very sturdy shoes made of badger skin.
所以要在旷野里头行走呢必须要穿上用海狗皮所做的鞋子因为只有那样才足够它的坚硬度呢来走在旷野里头。
The skin of a badger is very hard and sturdy that can last very rough climate and rough weather in the wilderness.
海狗皮啊其实是非常的粗糙非常的坚硬的这样呢才能够在旷野在恶劣的天气里头啊能够保护行走的人
So at this moment I want you to ponder the goodness of God
所以这个时候我想要你去默想神的恩惠
According to the rough climate and the rough life in the wilderness for 40 years
那就是在旷野里头那困难的四十年那天气恶劣的四十年
The Lord God gave them the right kind of garment to wear and the right kind of shoes to wear
神赐予他们适合的衣服来穿也赐予他们适合的鞋子来穿
All right, that brings our lesson to a close today
好今天呢我们的教导就到这里结束了
We'll continue this next week
下个星期我们会继续这个课题
Don't forget homework
哦，不要忘了还有功课哦
Again, I want you to meditate deeply Ezekiel chapter 16 verse 10
再次的我要请你去默想以西结书16章第10节
God bless you all
神赐福给你